Salut à tous, my name is Marion Buricatu. I am a French artist and I lived here in the United States since 2001. This video is about art and how to impress your friends and family at the museum with three easy facts.
Why are the abstract expressionist art movements so interesting? Well, merci for asking, and the answer is very simple. This American art movement is a one of a kind, and I'm going to tell you fun fact about its story. Okay, so here is a painting untitled by Mark Rothko, painted in 1955, and this painting is currently on view in the exhibition Reflection at the Museum of Fine Art in Boston until July 1st, so really you have a great opportunity to go and see it. Fact number one. Abstract Expressionism, the first real American art movement with worldwide recognition. So this art movement spanned roughly 40 years, but it really peaked in the 1950s. And it was composed mostly of poor artists living in New York City. So these guys, they had high egos, they had bravado, and they had self-importance. And one thing is that they took themselves very seriously. And they had one big goal. They wanted to move the capital of the art world from Paris to New York City. And you know what? They succeeded. So they took themselves very seriously, but they also wanted to be taken very seriously. And in the 50s in New York City, that was complicated because New York City was still a very traditional city with, I would say, classic taste when it came to art. And the Metropolitan did not expose their works in an exhibition. So the abstract expressionists were really mad, and they wrote an article in a newspaper with a picture of them all, and the article was called The Irascible. Fact number two, it's about rebirth and it's about freedom. So there are many different kinds of influences on this avant-garde art group, but I have decided to talk about two of them. The first one is World War II. So Europe is in shambles in the 50s. Americans start to realize what happened and the atrocities of the Holocaust and the bombings in Japan. So their painting is a rebirth. It's a clean slate from an unspeakable path. What they want to do is to get rid of all the rules in the art production, because they just think that this is wrong and they just want to start all over again. The second influence was the Cold War. So paranoia, fear, witch hunt, their painting is an expression of freedom. Okay, now fact number three, no focal point. Okay, so you have these guys with big egos, okay, and do you think that they will agree on anything? Well, no, they disagreed on everything. And one thing they really didn't like is to be called the abstract expressionists, because they felt that they were not supposed to belong to a group. But in fact, they did share some few techniques. There are some few techniques that they were really kind of had in common. What are these techniques? The first one is no focal point, meaning that the emphasis is distributed equally on the canvas. As you can see on this painting by the leader of the abstract expressionist movement, Willem de Kooning. Also, there is another thing that they have in common is that these were large-scale canvas. And the museum had to resize their rooms because their rooms were too small to have this painting exhibited. It is, for example, number 31 by Jackson Pollock, painted in 1950, and it's at the Museum of Modern Art in New York City. The dimensions are 9 feet tall, so taller than the room, and 17 feet wide. It is big. Okay, one more technique that they have in common is gestural painting, which means that they would use a brush and they would use wide movement of the arm. And that's really typical of this area and of this group. An example is the painting by Franz Kline called Spectre, painted in 1956, and it is at the Worcester Art Museum. Okay, so here are the three facts easy to remember about the Abstract Expressionist. This is the first American art movement with worldwide recognition. It's about rebirth and it's about freedom, but it's also about no focal point. Okay, now, if you want to impress your friends and family even more at the museum, or just have fun at your next family dinner, the next video is just for you, because I have created 7 trivia questions about the Abstract Expressionist.
Okay. Nice chatting with you. Abonne-toi, which means subscribe to my channel. Have fun and see you at the next video.